A few weeks ago, I went to the SWPACA. I can never remember that acronym. The Southwest Pop American Culture Association. I went to their yearly conference in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and had a blast. Well, what was it? Why did I go? And why should you go next year? And what does Joss Whedon have to do with all this? Keep watching to find out. Hi, I am Christine, the middle-aged fangirl. I have, or have had, depressive disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, and complex post-traumatic stress disorder. And it was film and fandom that really helped me heal. I talk about specific films, books, and TV shows that showed me how to deal with mental illness and the awesome power of the community of fandom. If this sounds interesting, please subscribe by hitting the little red subscribe button below. I was not familiar with the SWPACA before, but I came to find out that it's an academic conference for people who study pop culture and basically nerd heaven. I had impromptu hallway conversations about David Lynch and Captain America, and I heard from scholars that made me rethink just a little bit my position on the Joss Whedon controversy. It was pretty much the coolest group of fans, geeks, and nerds ever assembled. According to their website, the SWPACA is an organization that's an outlet for scholars, writers, and others interested in popular American culture to share ideas in a professional atmosphere and to increase awareness and improve public perceptions of America's cultural traditions and diverse populations. The SWPACA is not a con in the traditional sense. It's an academic conference. And for anyone who's never been to an academic conference, it's basically a con, except there's no celebrities, no vendor area, and the panels are a bit more researchy. But there are still lots of book tables. Before I get too much into the content, it might be good to define ACCA fan, because an ACCA fan is not always an academic, and the conference is for both. Traditionally, an academic is thought of as someone who has an advanced degree in something and continues to do research on it. They're also thought of as teaching at the college level. The word ACCA fan is a combination of academic and fan, and refers to an academic who identifies as a fan. The history of the term ACCA fan is fascinating in and of itself, but that's a topic for another video. Suffice to say, I did question my right to go to an academic conference because I don't have an advanced degree. But I asked my friend Lynn Zubrinus, who is an ACCA fan, I asked her on Twitter whether I could consider myself one. Her response was, "After having had hours-long, thinky, thoughtful conversations with you, I'd say absolutely." I love Lynn so much. Anyway, back to SWPACA. I was there to talk about the Squee Fangirl web series with my friends Hansi and Lynn, and that was totally fun, like always. But I want to talk about the other panels and all the other nifty stuff we did. There were panels on Supernatural and Doctor Who, Harry Potter, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, The Grateful Dead, science fiction, detective fiction, horror, game studies, Alfred Hitchcock, Blade Runner, and something called New Trends in Contemporary Zombies. And of course, a Once More with Feeling sing-along. To give you an idea of the kinds of stuff they talk about, I wanted to highlight just one panel I went to called The Works of Joss Whedon. There were three papers presented in the panel, the last one of which was called When Your Fave is Problematic, Reconsidering Joss Whedon's Feminism by Susan Finetti. Susan is a full professor of English at CSU Sacramento. She specializes in pop culture, English education, and American literature. She's the SWPACA chair for science fiction and fantasy, and also for the Works of Joss Whedon area. I will link her information in her website below. Well, I was so interested in what she had to say in the panel that I contacted her after the conference. We emailed back and forth a couple times, and she ended up making me rethink just slightly how I view Joss Whedon, and maybe even watch Buffy the Vampire Slayer. If you're not familiar with what happened regarding Joss Whedon last summer, check out my video, which I'll link below, called Three Tips for Dealing with the Joss Whedon Crisis. That video talks in detail about what happened. But to summarize it in one sentence for this video, Joss's ex-wife basically told everybody that he was a big jerk and not the feminist he made himself out to be. Now, my position, which I talk about in the video, is that you have to separate the art and the artist in order to enjoy the art, because otherwise you will never ever be able to watch, read, or listen to anything, because all artists are flawed, imperfect people. And Susan's thesis is that while an artist shouldn't be the primary focus of study, there are some instances where that's harder to set aside. And Whedon is one of those instances. In the case of Joss Whedon, he always made feminism a large part of his persona. And he was a hero to many, specifically because of his female characters. Now, I asked Susan what her response was to my position that you have to separate the art and the artist. Her response was that she agreed, except in certain circumstances where the author is harder to separate from his work, such as when you're talking about political pieces or autobiographical pieces. And it's because Joss Whedon painted himself as a feminist and invited the audience to view his work through that lens that makes it harder to separate the art from the artist in this case. Now, I have never been one of those people who idolizes Joss Whedon, the person. I guess I know too much about what went on in the golden age of Hollywood to ever idolize anyone. But I can see her point. I can see now that there's a difference between enjoying the work of, say, Alfred Hitchcock, who was also a big, awful jerk, especially to women, but who didn't put himself out there as someone to be modeled after, and he didn't ask people to view his works through a certain lens. He just made movies he thought people would like. And then there's Whedon, who used his self-proclaimed position as a feminist to increase his celebrity status. Now, that in itself was just totally fascinating to me. But aside from that issue, which I wanted to highlight just to give you an idea of the kinds of things that are talked about at the conference, I also asked Susan, why study pop culture? Why is it even important? And I loved her answer so much that I'm going to read it verbatim. The things that are popular, that are beloved, influence who we are as people, as community, as society. We need to study the things that people flock to for enjoyment, and we need to analyze why and from where that enjoyment derives. To study popular culture is to study who we are. I am deeply suspicious of people who turn up their noses at the things others love. And I would add that pop culture helps us deal with the crap that life throws at us. We view our heroes and they model how to respond to crisis situations, and then we find community within fandom, people who share our same passions. So, if you are in any way an ACA fan, I encourage you to check out the SWPACA, whose website I will link below. I will definitely be going next year, and in fact, I will probably be going early so I can catch all of the days, because there were so many really cool panels that I missed. If you like this video, even just a little bit, or if it helped you, please consider subscribing by hitting the little red subscribe button, because film and fandom are good for the soul.